Hi guys, Yaka here. So this time we are giving you some advice on the achievements for Paladin. So I have three different decks for you which you could use in order to complete the quests. So there's a little bit more intricacy into this. For the holy spells, I would suggest you to use a secret Librum. Paladin, just over the course of the game, throwing out different Librum spells and then throwing down Lady Liadrin will easily get you to do this one specifically. Just be aware of that you need to count to the five different holy spells, and you might do a little bit of suboptimal plays once in a while, but it should definitely be doable, and I'll show you a deck for that. I'm kind of made my own, but with a little bit of inspiration for this next one, where you have 600 minions that you need to buff with Invigorating Sermon. I actually got half the way there through playing Arena. Arena, the Invigorating Sermon is really good in there, but for Standard it hasn't really taken off, and I wouldn't say that it's great. I'm still above. I'm on a 53% win rate with the deck I'm using, with some sample size in there, but I'll show you that. And together with that, I also use Party Up in the same deck as Invigorating Sermon, allowing to get even more minions generated to buff with Invigorating Sermon, and that'll be included in the same deck as that one. The last one, I've constructed a deck. It took me two tries to do it, and the deck is, honestly speaking, awful. But if you want to do it, I haven't won with the deck at all, but I managed to do the achievement in just two tries. It'll probably take a little bit more. Sometimes I won't guarantee you that you'll get there in two tries, but I'll show you the deck anyway, just so you can get a feel of it. And let's try and look at the first deck, which is the Secret Librum Paladin. Secret Librum Paladin has been around for quite a while, and you kind of know if you played sometime in the past, over the course of multiple expansions, I guess, that you need to discount your Librum. So Elder Attendant is what you need in the beginning. So that's really what you want a mulligan for. Knight of Anointment can be there as well, and then you can draw into some different buff things, like your Librum of Wisdom, Hand of a Doll, and then you need to curve out and continuously discount your Librums until you can finish the game through sheer board presence and taking this mid-range approach to it. The deck is still good, even though it's been nerfed a couple of times, and you are still able to get some good wins in there. It's not like the 60% win rate as it were in the past, but it's decent, and you can definitely still manage to do so in Legend, or on the way to Legend, so it's not a bad deck to complete the achievement with. Let's have a look at how the deck actually plays.
Uther versus Garrosh.
Victory or death!
I will fight with...
I want to go for Elder Attendant or Knight of Anointment initially. It's the war. Let's see if it's Rush or Control. At least I get to tutor out a lot of the secrets, which is good. Just getting to thin the deck a little bit. Okay, so it's Rush. I think it's a little bit better than Control, but yeah, I don't know.
Just
get the first secret out there. Galloping Savior. Probably take a few turns before that's activated. Then it's probably Narrowlax afterwards.
Be thirsty.
So it's actually this one. Mm, Gift of Luminance if he ignores the Scorpid?
For justice!
Job done.
Oh my god. Seems good. Oh, you got your own little Scorpid. Where are we? No. Oof. Oof. That's a little bit annoying. Blade Master Samuro. That's not enough right now, at least.
Being my folly.
Let's just try and do this. Hoping for Azera Awakens. Nightmare will do fine with Blade Master Samuro. If he could be so kind as to play a little bit more. More minions, please. Shield Slam. Okay, that's a little bit annoying. I'll actually give him some armor. I think it's still worth it.
My blade seeks vengeance. I hear and obey. Blade Storm!
Okay, green. I think that's actually fine.
Wretched story. Loot!
Okay. I guess that's fine. So what do I want to do now? I guess I want to draw. And then what? Maybe get out a secret first.
For justice.
Reckoning. Do I dream? I don't think so. I don't think so. No? And then he does not get the card draw, actually. That's good. Now I need to draw my Librium discount cards. Come on, come on. I guess I can protect against that. There's actually no more secrets in there, is there? Well, there's this one. Restore health. Looking at those two guys, I need this. That one.
That's
it. There's my arc.
Awake at last.
Can't think of seeing you. Okay. And I guess we will draw a snack run.
I won't go down without a fight.
Dude, at least his Frenzy's not gonna proc. There we go, let's see what we discover. Another Gift of Luminance. Or Blessing of Kings. Oh, Gift of Luminance, I think that's it. I guess I could go for Librium of Hope just to corrupt Librium of Judgment. But I really would like the discount card soon, like Elder Truth Seeker, Elder Attendant. was once we played it. Elder Attendant, yes please.
I cannot wait to read this.
And then let's get this one going. Actually, the only concern I have right now, at least, is if I'm so much ahead that my opponent will concede, but there's brawls and stuff, so I guess let's just take it easy. I'll put a Librem on this one, then it won't die. We can do a value trade.
Reporting for duty. Purity.
If I want to finish the game, and I guess I want to do so, but you get the gist of it. Play that one sometimes, five times, and then Lady Liard will get you five copies left, and then you can replay it on one minion up to multiple times. Yeah, because it's a holy spell. See this here, it's holy. So that's the main gist of it. But it's powerful enough that we might end up just winning here. Denied. You don't even get to play the rank 3 spell. Just stall a little bit. But we want to win the game. Nature spell. Right now we only have like a few. And still we haven't got them discounted since.
I challenge you to Makara!
So what do you want to go for, mate? Elder Truth Seeker, there we go.
I'm going to throw the book at
you. What a game!
To battle!
There we go. Doesn't make too much sense, I know.
Justice.
I really want to play this as much as I can. Just for a chance to get the Lady Liardric, because that's gonna be 3, I think. See if we can clear this one. There we go. Shoot the orc. Bad move.
What a game!
And flick. And this way, we're just gonna do this.
What a game!
We'll see.
Reporting for duty.
I should have played it enough times now that if I hit this one in, it's almost a board clear, man. Oh, it is a board clear, isn't it? Oh, almost a board clear. Night of Anointment will get me there for the quest.
May the light grant you peace.
Leave a little wisdom. Let's just do this to get another one. What you need in order to complete the quests. So this is merely just me showing you guys how to do it, because there's more optimal ways to do it, but that's the main gist of it. We should be far enough ahead now, because if he's going to do a conditioning on that one there, I'm just gonna push it back, and then if he just goes face now, we win. Right. And we do not win 10, 13. Not yet, anyway. But this might be a conceit. There we go. So this next one is a little bit more intricate. You don't have any, of course you don't have any Librams in here, but what you do have is that you have a lot of the Adventurers. So you, in the beginning, you want to go for your Knight of Anointment or Meeting Stone, so you want to keep those. Loot Hoarder is a cycle card, Burger McGurgle, you also want to keep those. So those are kind of the cards they want to keep in the beginning. If you have one of those, then you can consider keeping a Devouring Ectoplasm or Goody Two Shields, and I might even want to keep one of those guys if I am on the coin, because then you have a good turn 2 play, so that's really great to have that opportunity. Some of the combos you need to be aware of in here is that you have some board clear. You have one board clear tool, and that is Blademaster Cimmero, which you can use in conjunction with Conviction, but preferably with Blessing of Kings or maybe even Blessing of Authority. So it plays kind of like a Swarm aggro deck. Not as well as maybe a Zulok, but it's still that kind of playstyle. You need to swarm the board continuously. Another good combo to mention is if you get your Seed Cloud Buckler out, you start to hit your opponent in the face, and then on turn 7, you activate the last charge of the Seed Cloud Buckler, and while you have just played Party Up. That allows you to get a full board of either Poison or Rush or Wind Fury Adventurers. And that's a sticky board for you to then buff with Conviction on the following turn, or maybe some of your other buff for instance like Invigorating Sermon. That's a lot of damage if that board gets to stick. One of the challenges you do face is against, for instance, decks like Control Warlock, Control decks in general, which are really good at clearing boards and making sure that nothing sticks. And then for the late game, you have Alexstrasza to close out the game. So this is kind of an interesting deck. I'm at 55% with it, but initially I lost some of the matches getting into the intricacies of it. But you'll get to play it a few times if you want to play through and get the Invigorating Sermon. But you should get at least like 15 minions on average to hit that with the Invigorating Sermon, but getting to 600 total, that will take some games before you get there. Sometimes you get lucky and get two activated over the course of a game, and of course you take that. But a good way of thinking about Invigorating Sermon is to use, for instance, Party Up or generating some minions. Even just a hero power also progresses the quest or progresses the achievement somewhat. Enough said about that, let's have a look at the deck in action.
My quest begins.
I will fight with honor.
This is actually a pretty good starting hand. There's drawings here, there's some early game minions. I think I'm just gonna keep this. Getting Murga McGurgling. It's also great because then if I draw Alexstrasza, whew, pardon me, then I still have a good minion to draw with Talon. But Meeting Stone is first, and then we'll see where we go from there. Full Keeper and Full Mulligan. That's great. Well, if he gets what he needs, then it's not great. But right now, it doesn't seem like he gets what he needs. Let's see if it's a death rattle or if it's an OTK. I think OTK is the worst one for me. Okay, let's see if we can manage to get some triples or quadruplicates. Triples or quadruples. Difficult word to pronounce, apparently. Okay, Devout Adventurer is, I guess, the same as Murga. That's not the same, of course not, but I just want to figure out if I want to shuffle in the Prime.
The answer is here.
Just play around. Well, I think if I want to play around, we'll use this instead, so you can't clear it with the Hero. But the Immolation Aura was the one I was thinking about. That's the one I wanted to play around, and if that were the case, then a Devout Adventurer would have been best. Okay, he also got some moves. Okay. Okay, that, well, I'll leave a 2-2. So maybe I just ignore it for now. And then he needs to invest both the Hero Power and this one into clearing the Goody Two Shields. Then I can do over the Devout and the Murga, and instead I also want to start with the Sea Club. I guess I can wait one more turn. Wait one more turn. Pardon me. Let's keep it awkward for him. But this is when he's playing the. It's death rattle. An invigorating sermon. I think I want to wait with that one until we've managed to hit a board of party up. I think that's good enough.
Nothing gets through.
That was a little bit annoying, honestly speaking, because I wanted to hit that one, but I think this is fine.
You don't scare me.
Then I'm gonna use this one. It's gonna leave the turn a little bit awkward for him. That's what I wanted to go for. And then I can have one more hit with the seat, with the buckler, until we get to turn 7.
Okay.
I think I'm still gonna hit. That one. I also want to heal a little bit, I think, yeah. These two guys, and let's deny him a Hand of Gul'dan. Hand Skull of Gul'dan, not Hand of Gul'dan. There's bits of Gul'dan everywhere, apparently. That is okay-ish. You can clear the board. But that's it, right?
You want my respect?
Okay.
Burn.
That was annoyingly good for him. Okay.
Maybe I'm not gonna do anything. Grant you peace.
Really? Sure. Definitely not bad. He wants to clear those for sure. And then. Then I should have a party up. And then we can have a bunch of divine shields as well. And let's see if we can hit like a triple or quadruple, like we mentioned before. And then if enough stuff survives, then I have two invigorating sermons to follow up on the party up. Powerful, I tell you guys. But this one, he's quite annoying. Ace Hunter Cream.
Do you hear, Aminor?
What, Joe? Stop playing those taunts. Alrighty, I'm gonna clear those two guys, and then we'll see.
Back, monster.
And then remember to play this one first. Hey. So I think I'm gonna do what? Clear this one, I guess.
You
this one here.
Me.
And then I'm gonna do this one here. And then clear that. I think that's the most optimal play. And we can double Invigorating Sermon. He's not gonna clear all of it. Maybe a couple of them. But that's gonna be a bunch of buffs. No, denied. Okay, maybe he's got the last laugh, but that was funny, I tell you. If that were me, I would be like,
My hunt goes
what
on.
Have they done to me?
Okay, that's nice. He's gonna clear one of them. That's fine. Because now we're gonna go completely nuts here.
Back, monster! Back, monster!
12.
You owe me.
We're gonna do this.
Clear
that one, then go face. He gets to clear one more with the Murloc, and that's okay, I guess. I do have a bunch more damage with this one. That's 6. Right now it's lethal. But it's not gonna be on the next turn. Then I kind of need another conviction. Then we're there. But that's a bunch of minions buffed with the sermon. Could also just wait a little bit. Of course, I'm going to play the Hand of the Doll, see what I draw first. And then I could end with a Blessing of Authority if he doesn't really play anything.
Goes on.
Did he yield? Did he heal up? There's only three cards to choose from. Buddy! Sermon, too powerful, is that it? Okay. He hasn't given up yet. He's just smashing up his chair or something. Okay, let's see if we manage to draw into lethal. That's the conviction. I have 16, so I need 10 more. 6 there. Knight of Anointment might get me there, so I think I need to do this first. And if I get a Blessing of Kings, then we're there. There we go. Back monster. GG. You managed to get there. That's such a powerful turn after a party up. It needs to be mentioned that I will leave deck codes in the description for all these decks. But this last one, I need to warn you, it's not good and you will probably most likely lose with it, and it's just a matter of you getting that achievement activated. So I put in all the secrets that we have and a bit of card draw and also some that you tutor out, of course, with Sword of the Fallen. What the trick is that you do not want to play the secrets initially. You want to make sure your opponent has some resources available to trigger all the secrets, because you need all 5 secrets to trigger in one turn. And some of the synergy stuff that you are looking for is, for instance, maybe Galloping Savior, but then of course Avenge and Noble Sacrifice and Judgment of Justice. Those 3, at least, they are guaranteed to proc once an opponent attacks. So if an opponent has something on the board or a weapon equipped, those 3 are guaranteed to proc. Then it's a matter of figuring out if your opponent has a broad board of strong minions, then it could be that you try and go for a Reckoning, or alternatively, if it's a spell heavy deck, maybe it's a mage or something like that, then you want to go for an Oh My Yogg in conjunction with something else, which late game probably could be a Galloping Savior. It is a bit tricky, and sometimes your opponent will only like trigger 3 or 4 and you'll be like, ah, come on, help me out here. So not in the early game. You might really quickly be able to drop all the secrets, but your opponent needs to have some resources available in order for your opponent to trigger all the secrets. So try and see if you can find that sweet spot. The first game I didn't manage to, even though I got the secrets almost there. The next one we managed to do it, and that was 1-9 mana for the opponent, I think. I'll try to do a game with it, but do not expect too much out of it, but you will get the main gist of it. It's a matter of surviving until you can get all the secrets in there. A combo worth mentioning is that you are likely, with High Abyss Allura, and you play one of your secrets, that you will draw one of the other ones out there. So this is really a matter of tutoring out the secrets. This might be easier in a while, just dropping a Black Knight, or what? No, not a Black Knight, Mysterious Challenger. But I haven't tried that. I wanted to do this for standard, the standard decks that we have right now. But it might be something that you can drop in the comments if that were easier for you, if you managed to go that route instead. Enough said, let's have a look at the deck in action, and do remember to follow the channel. It's really great for me to see whenever you guys are following. Let's have a look at the deck.
The light shall bring victory.
I will fight with honor.
Okay, so this deck is bad, and we're not gonna win. Pure and simple. But let's keep, there's 3 secrets here, doesn't look like it, but I can play one secret, drop the High Abyss Allura, and drop the other one, and then we might get another secret here. So that's what I wanna go for. And against Priest, well, there's a chance that we might actually get there. Pass.
Looking forward to the fireworks.
You sure do, Anduin.
Happy Midsummer Fire Festival!
Sure. Whenever you can, just play something. Store. And a goodie two shields. Perfect. Fine. And then when you develop support sometime, we might get another equality. Equality consecration is for a hard reset on his board. Let's see if it's necessary. What do you got? Two holy smites. Just consecration, I guess. That's fine.
Repent.
I want him to generate a bunch of stuff. Let's see. We're not at that point. I want to have. He needs to have a lot more mana. And I only have like. On 8, I would have like. Four secrets, maybe. Noble sacrifice. So I have the other one, so I can sacrifice this one and do this. But for noble sacrifice and avenge to work together, I also need, like I do here, to have a minion out there. But that could work. I can ignore that one. Sword of the Fallen to avenge. Now just need the mana, and then maybe we can get there. Avenge, noble sack. So if I do get like a Sword of the Fallen, then we're there. Now I just need 2 mana, additional mana to also get a recruit out there. Then we should be able to proc all of it. And I think he's at a high enough mana level right now that this is okay. Sure, steal my stuff. See if I care. Not a lot of damage. So, let's do this. Hit that one, and then we'll see. Okay, now it's just a sword. That's 2 out of 20. 10% chance of drawing it. And still, he's not presenting a lot of damage. Challenge with Hayabusa Lura, which I could also use. I need to go to 9 mana. And it might be that we don't draw into. Draw into the spell because I do have a Sword of the Fallen, and we're there. We are gonna try this. Remember, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Remember to drop all of these first, and these three work in perfect conjunction with each other. There, Avenge, Justice, Oh My Ark. So those four first, and then we get like a Galloping Savior or hopefully a Reckoning. Galloping Savior. Hopefully he's gonna play 3 things. And if we manage this, yay! We're still gonna lose. Yep, and that's gonna proc 3 of them. Let's hope he plays nicely. Avenge. Come on, play a spell. Play a spell. 2 more things. Well, one of them needs to be a spell. Great. And then play 1 more thing. For 1 mana. You can do it, I know. Come on, you can do it. Come on. That's why I wanted it to be Reckoning. 1 more thing. Come on. No. He's not playing nice.
become the hero.
But you get the gist of it.
Brightness calls
for justice.
There we go. That's how we managed to get our old fairy spells out, and you need a little bit more collaboration from your opponent than what I got this game. We will finish off the game, but that needs to stand as its own, and then maybe we'll get there. I think this is enough. You guys won't have to suffer through a priest beating up on me, like torturing me slowly, so we'll just concede here. But that's the idea behind the deck to make it work, and hopefully you will encounter an opponent which is a little bit more collaborative than the one I just faced here. Thanks for watching, guys.
The victory is yours.